Hello students and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com. Before starting this video, let me tell you about RBI Grade B 2018 course by Team Bank Exams Today. So we are providing daily video classes for both phase 1 and phase 2. So along with the video classes, you will get the complete study material and you will get the full length mock test series for phase 1 and phase 2. 15 tests for phase 1 and 10 tests each for the each subject of phase 2. We will also provide the assistance for the interviews. So in case you are interested in RBI Grade B course, you can directly call me, or the link to join the course is available in the description. Please check the description. So let's start. So today I'm going to discuss the first bi-monthly monetary policy statement released by the RBI. So let's start. So the bi-monthly monetary policy statement, it is released by, first of all, it is released by the Monetary Policy Committee, right? The Monetary Policy Committee, in which there are 5 members, including the Governor of Reserve Bank of India. And it is released under the section 45ZM, right? It is released under the section 45ZM of Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. Then the various highlights of the resolution of Monetary Policy Committee. The repo rate and the reverse repo rate, they were kept unchanged. No changes in the rates. The repo rate is still 6% and the reverse repo rate is still 5.75%. Marginal standing facility, MSF, and the bank rate is still 6.25%. What is MSF and what are reverse repo rate? Repo rate, I have already done a lecture. Please check that financial management folder. The MSF is the rate at which the scheduled bank can borrow funds from the RBI overnight, right, against the approved government security. So this is what MSF is. So this is important for RBI Grade B exam. So the repo rate is 6%, reverse repo rate is 5.75%, MSF and bank rate are 6.25%, right? So these are the few rates that are kept unchanged, no changes. So what is the goal of, now what is the goal of Monetary Policy Committee? What is the goal of the this committee? I mean, what they are targeting at? The medium term goal that shared by this committee, Monetary Policy Committee, is to achieve consumer price index inflation of 4% with a band of plus or 2-% with this while supporting the growth. So this is the goal. What this committee is targeting, this committee is targeting at achieving and, you know, keeping the consumer price index inflation of 4%, right? So that's what the target of this committee is, the medium term target. And the decision in this Monetary Policy Committee, there are 5 members and 4 members, actually these members are like Chetan Ghate, Pami Dua, Ravinder Dholakia, Viral V. Acharya and Urjit Patel voted in the favor, and Michelle Dib Batra Patra. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are total 6 members, out of which 5 members voted in the favor of no change in the rates, while 1 member said there should be an increase in the basis point, in the increase in the repo rate, right? Increase in the policy rate by 25 basis points. So consumer price index inflation projections, in this report they mentioned, the RBI mentioned, the CPI inflation reprojected at 4.7% to 5.1% for April and September and 4.4% for October to March 2019. So why that actually increased, why there is a change in that inflation? The reason is there is an impact because of the HRA, change in the HRA policy, right? There is an increase in HRA under 7th Central Pay Commission. That's why this inflation, it had an impact on the inflation, right? So CPI inflation in Q4 of financial year 18 is now reprojected at 4.5%. It is not that important. The reason was the decline in inflation of food. Not that important. The previous one was little important. Very important question, students. The projected GDP according to RBI. The projected GDP, according to RBI, in financial year 2019, the projected GDP is 7.4%, previously as against 6.6% in financial year 2018, right? So these are the two projections. This one is very important. Please remember, the projected GDP growth rate for the year 2019 is 7.4%, students, 7.4%. Okay, while in 2018 it is 6.6%, 7.4%. This is very, very important, student, very important question for the exam. So uncertainties surrounding the baseline inflation path. So there are certain uncertainties. First of all, there can be a fiscal deficit, because suppose if the government overspent, that is the most important point. Then the increase in HRA, that it's also having a, you know, impact on the inflation. Then the change in the MSP policy, change in the, you know, formula to calculate the MSP, this one, HRA, and the fiscal slippage. And in case there is a bad monsoon, it will have, because we are an agriculture, you know, we are an agriculture economy, agriculture based economy right now. I mean, service sector is, you know, is contributing a lot, but still a big portion of the population is dependent upon the agriculture. So it's important. Volatility in the crude oil, still we are dependent upon the crude oil. So any, you know, changes in the in any big change in the prices of that crude oil, that will badly impact the inflation, right? So these are the various factors that can impact according to RBI's notification. Crude oil, monsoon, fiscal deficit, the fiscal deficit, fiscal slippage, what they call, the revision in HRA according to 7th pay scale, and the change in the MSP formula. So these are the five reasons. So highlights of statement on development, developmental and regulatory policies. So these are the few highlights given or shared, also released with the bi-monthly policy. So let's start. What are the various highlights? So first of all, Indian accounting standards. This Indian accounting standard, first of all, according to RBI, they were, you know, from 1st of April 2018, they were, you know, it was decided that it will be implemented from 1st of April 2018, but now they will be implemented from 1st of April 2019. They have been delayed by 1 year. In Indian accounting standards, they have been postponed by 1 year. This is important. Indian accounting standards, from which year Indian accounting standards will be implemented? It is 1st of April 2019. It is a very, very important question, students. And Indian accounting standards for banks, Indian accounting standard for banks will be applicable only on the scheduled commercial banks. It won't be applicable on RRBs and payment banks. So Indian accounting standards will be applicable only on scheduled commercial banks, not on RRBs and payment banks, right? Very important. So there is an announcement related to the payment banks. So in the recent times, the payment banks became really popular, the online banking became really popular. So there are a lots of, you know, discussions about the data leakage. That's why the RBI gave a notification that to reduce the risk, it has been decided that all the payment system operators will ensure that is not directly related to payment banks, right? That is related to online banking, right? That is not directly related to payment banks. There is an error. So it has been decided that all the payment system operator will ensure that the data related to payment systems operated by them only stored inside the country within a period of 6 months. You cannot, you know, store the data related to the customers or data related to the Indian customers in a server that is located out of the country. So that server should be located within the country. It is not directly related to payment banks. It is actually related to any payment system operator that is providing online, you know, transactional services. So introduction of rupee swapations. So swaption. So it is, you know, I have already done a lectures on swaps, and I have already done a lecture on options. So swaption is a combination of both swaps and options. So what are swaptions? Swaptions are nothing but it is an option. It is an option. One person is paying the option premium to buy this option. To enter into an interest rate swap or any other type of swap in exchange for an option premium, the buyer gains the right but not the obligation to enter into specified swap agreement with the issuer on a specified future date. Students, I highly recommend you to please check out that swap lecture, very important. So in December 2016, RBI introduced rupee interest rate swaps option, rupee interest rate option IRO. Only the plain vanilla interest rate option was released, but now the even NRI is allowed here. And subsequently, market participant, including the corporates, have expressed the need for swaption to effectively manage the interest rate risk. Students, please watch that swaps lectures, right? The swaps lecture, it is available. Please go through it. It is very important. It is available in the FM folder. Go to the FM folder, and then in the FM folder, there is derivatives. You will find the swaps lecture. Okay, please check out it. I hope if you are reading a newspaper, even if you are, if you are active online, if you are active on social media, Bitcoins are and the virtual currencies are blocked. Any commercial bank, suppose if you want to transfer money from a bank, any scheduled commercial bank or any organization that is, regulated by the RBI, they cannot transfer the money into that virtual currency wallet. No, we call it Bitcoin wallet or any other virtual currency wallet. The banks are not allowed to transfer money into Bitcoin wallet. So you won't be able to buy the Bitcoins anymore. So why the RBI did it? Because there is a news that RBI is going to bring their own digital currency, and there it's a rumor actually, maybe, but its name is from last 6 7 days. There was a rumor that India is going to bring its own virtual currency named as Lakshmi. So RBI came up with this notification, and we are quite sure that there will be a digital currency called Lakshmi. And this Bitcoin thing, that's why this Bitcoins and the virtual currencies are blocked or banned. Rapid change in the landscape of payment industry, along with the factors such as emergence of this and that, while many central banks are still engaged in a debate. So this report will be submitted by the end of June 2018. So, but this one is important. You cannot transfer money from your bank to a virtual currency wallet, and there are many exchanges in virtual currency exchanges in India. The banks cannot transfer money into these wallets. So that's important. Revamping of the lead bank scheme. So student, what is a lead bank? Under the lead bank scheme, it was introduced in 1969. Important. In this scheme, the RBI, they assigned the lead bank role to a bank which is having a lot of resources, which is having a bigger network. Assignment of lead role to individual bank at a district level, a proper district is allotted to a bank having relatively large network of branches in the rural areas, given a district and endowed with the adequate financial and manpower resources, are generally entrusted with the lead responsibility. So suppose, let's say, to provide banking facilities in rural areas, let's say there is a small you can say district Khanna near Ludhiana. It's near Ludhiana, near my place. I am from Ludhiana. So there is Khanna, right? Let's say still banking services are not active here, not properly active here. So RBI entrusted SBI here, because SBI is very is actually, there are a few branches of SBI on Khanna. They give the lead bank role to the SBI. Now SBI will behave like a leader for coordinating the efforts of all credit institutions in the allotted district to increase the flow of credit to agriculture, small scale industry, other economic activities, including the priority sector lending. So this one bank will act as a leader. Now the RBI is going to revamp this. So there was a committee of executive directors and which are going to submit the report within 15 days, right? So that's all for today, students. Please install the Bank Exams Today mobile application and give us 5 stars on Bank Exams Today mobile app, right? And I recommend you to please join the RBI Grade B course, 2018 course. If you haven't joined till now, please join the course. So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a very nice day. Bye.